Hello, YouTube, and have a Merry Christmas. Of course, I'm doing this like about a day beforehand, but you know, I don't really care because this would be released for you guys for tomorrow instead. I'm not gonna try and do this as a daily or an hourly or even a twice a day type of thing because I do not have that kind of energy to be putting videos out that often. But I will put them out as often as I can. So if you like this stuff, then just go ahead and let me know. I am on Twitter, so you can always DM me there. I should be available for all DMs. If I'm not, Jen, just send out a tweet to me saying, "Hey, bitch, open up your DMs." So I'm gonna go ahead and talk about the one thing that I've seen a few people already touch on before, and that's about Onision's body image project that he had started. And I have heard a few stories to what I was reading over, reading it, because I can't stand his fucking voice for the life of me. Reading over his YouTube video about the body image thing and the reason why he'd stopped it. And this is what Onision had stated about why he was doing it and why he had ended up stopping it. "I was going to end the body image series as it attracted a lot of baseless drama. People were acting like I had violated some law or policy when, in fact, the US law is on my side and so is YouTube policy. So why did I discontinue body image series when it was doing so much good for so many people? Literally, look at people tweeting about me helping them with their body image issues. The body image video is literally helped a huge amount of people. So asking myself obvious questions and seeing people still coming to me, thanking me for helping them with their self-esteem or body image issues, how could I not continue? People change sometime for the better. I think I'm stronger now. I mean, how can I expect you guys to be confident in yourselves through my message if I can't be confident in myself?" And then he proceeds to list off a few videos called "Do You Guys Prefer Curvy or Skinny Girls?" "Yes, Fat Chicks." "Are You a Fat Girl? Tell and How?" "Fat, Thick, Curvy, or Skinny?" So clearly that Onision's not very finicky about the type of women that he dates outside of the fact that he prefers young women. He doesn't care if they're young and fat or they're young and skinny or they're young and black or if they're young and Muslim. He just likes young girls. And that's been given with his recent past about how he was dating a 17-year-old when he was like 28. He's now 30 to 31, and his wife is 20, maybe even 21. But the thing is, she's still young. She was still a minor when he was dating with her, and there is a possibility that, yeah, there would be some sexual influences involved. So that given, I can actually safely say that he does prefer younger women. There might be a point in his life where he looks to his wife, decides to divorce her, and goes after the next available 18-year-old fresh off of the market. So yeah, that will be a huge thing to look into. And I'm only speculating about the wife thing, and it's not 100% guarantee for all I know that he loves her a very long time and all this other stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and break down his sentence here and specify what exactly drawn him to really stop this. And I'm very glad that he stopped this. I'm disgusted that he actually did this for as long as he did and didn't get in trouble for it. But I'm very glad that he stopped it in regards of what he's claiming and versus the actual law. "I was going to end the body image series as it attracted a lot of baseless drama." Now, he's assuming this, and I'm going to tell you guys right now, to assume it makes an asset of you and me. He's assuming that the body image series is attracting a lot of baseless drama. And what he's going off of with baseless drama is drama that's starting up for no reason. You know, like how feminism accuses all men, even men who were accused of rape, to be rapists, and you find out later on that those said men are not rapists, but are being accused of it for baseless drama issues because of popularity. Now, there's nothing baseless about wanting the body image series to have young women. I mean, as long as those women are like 18 to 24, for an example. Those are still technically young women. And by the law standards, you are perfectly safe to post up their half nudes to full on nudes on the internet without getting into trouble, as long as they give consent. No. From what I understand, though, his body image series didn't just involve these young women between the ages of 18 to 24. It was involving girls as young as 13, maybe even 12 or 11, depending on the images themselves, that he was posting up in their underwear with his YouTube name, Onision, on their body somewhere. And that is actually considered a form of pedophilia. While the images themselves are not full-blown naked, they are still minors, they're still in their underwears, and they're still posing sexually for you, for an individual, for the camera, to be posted up on the internet. Regardless if the children are saying that they consent or not, they are not legally allowed to give consent. Their parents or guardians are to give consent. And I can guarantee that the parents and guardians did not give consent for their children to do this kind of shit. Because teenagers have been known to do things behind their parents' backs for revenge reasons, because they want to feel special about themselves, because they want to be a bad person, because of oppression by the household, you know, all sorts of things. I mean, I was a teenager before, about 15 years ago. Yeah. It's all right there. If you want to be a teenager, you're going to be rebellious, and that's perfectly fine in being rebellious. But what's not perfectly fine is asking 13-year-olds or taking the images of 13-year-olds with your name on their body and posting them up on the internet. These kids, yes, kids, these young teens do not have consent to give to you to post their images up. And that is against the law. People are acting like I violated some law or policy in the United States law, when in fact the United States law is on my side and so is YouTube policy. Here's the thing with that. The United States law is not on your side. And as somebody who's been role-playing for about almost 20 years now, I came to understand several laws, including what would be considered a pedophile and what is not when it involves the law. If you, as somebody who is 18 years or older, are role-playing with somebody who is about 13, having access to the internet and discovering role-play for the first time in their life, you do not do cyber sex at all. You do not do erotic fantasy role plays at all. You don't do those kinds of role plays with these minors because you get in trouble with the law. Yes, you would be classified as a pedophile because your role play partner or a couple of people who you role play as had their parents or guardians find the logs between you and that said individual and get you in trouble and registered as a sex offender. And because you are over the age of 18, or because of the fact that you are the age of 18, you get in trouble for being a pedophile because you did not verify the age of the person you're role playing with. It is why there's so many people out there, as much as they want to roleplay with older people, think that this is a bias on their ages, when in fact roleplayers over the age of 18 take the time to actually defend themselves and protect themselves from getting arrested and being registered as a sex offender. What you did, Onision, is a lot worse, because you did have the ability to check out these girls' age and decided not to do that and still include them into your photos, into this collage that you had created for body imaging. It would be one thing, it would be completely different if you just took these images, went through and filtered them and said, oh yeah, that one's 13, so that's not going to be a problem. All these parents have to do, especially the one mother who found out about this, about these photos, all they have to do is put together a lawsuit against you, register you as a sex pedophile, as a sex offender, with that video as proof, with this video stating that what you're saying is not against the law, and you'd be in trouble. Because this video right here, your body image and self-esteem video, this is a confession that you did do this. And this is what will get you signed away for prison for probably about 20 years, so you don't get to see your wife, you don't get to see your child for as your child grows up. And yes, there's an and to this. You will be permanently registered as a sex offender. Something that will never come off of your record. Because you had videos. You had pictures. Probably still have. I don't know if you deleted them or not. I really hope that you did delete them. But I don't know. Because I'm not you. I don't look at your computer or anything like that. You have these photos, or had these photos. and that would make you very liable as being a sex offender. You have the images of 13-year-olds, probably as even as young as 11-year-olds, in their underwear, with your name on their bodies, posing for you in a video, and that right there is what is against the law. You did not decide to delete those photos. You did not decide to say, hey, I want these people to be at least 18 years because I can get in trouble with the law due to pedophilia acts and such forth. No, you decided to go through with this, and then you're going to end up losing yourself because of the law is actually against you, considering that this is a federal offense, Onision. This is how you get in trouble in the United States permanently. Not just your state, but the entire United States. So why did I discontinue the body image series when it was doing so much good for so many people? Apparently you didn't answer that, but I guess I can answer that for you. You discontinued it because you realized that you were in fact getting some flack for it, decided that it was going to draw too much attention to you, and would possibly get you in trouble for doing so. Just because you think it's deleted from the internet does not mean that it is actually deleted in general. I bet you I can ask anybody for the actual video who follows you, whether or not they like you or not, and they will be willing to provide that video for me instead. And literally break down everything in that video about what is wrong with what you did. So the reason why you discontinued and actually backtracked to remove the said video with the minors in it is to protect your very image, which is currently defamed as being nothing more than a crazy bastard. So asking myself obvious questions and seeing people still coming to me, thanking me for helping them with their self-esteem, body image issues, how could I not continue? You don't continue. Mainly because you just drew way too much attention to yourself and are more likely to face persecution by the federal government than by any other government within the United States at this point. As I'm saying, right now all it takes is one of these parents to find out what you did. One of these parents to find out that their child has sent these images in to you. One of these parents to report this to the federal government and get you in trouble with the FBI. One of these parents will permanently render you as a sex offender, would render you as a pedophile because of what you actually did. It is against the law. People who take pictures of kids playing at a park, guess what? They get told that they get questioned about pedophilia. The police are called in, and if their camera's exposed to showing images of young children in underwear or naked even, they get into serious trouble because they become registered sex offenders. They are pedophiles. If male adults as old as you as an example, are hanging around a high school taking pictures of young women or even young men and have photos of young women and young men or teenagers in their underwear, and they're caught red-handed because the police show up, they get in trouble too. What you did is in fact against the United States law. It is in fact against the federal law, not just the United States law. It is against the federal law. So you stopping this is not helping them with their self-esteem or body image issues. It's you stopping this so that you don't get into serious repercussions, which is, by the way, going to be thrown out the door once this video gets out there. By the way, I have downloaded this video. So if you do decide to delete this particular video, then you're screwed because it's already saved. People change, sometimes for the better. I think I'm stronger now. No, you're not stronger. You're more educated now. You're sitting there making up bogus lies about how this is in fact perfectly legal within the United States law and the YouTube policy. I don't think YouTube policies would actually approve of this kind of stuff. In fact, I would think that as soon as it got flagged for the inappropriate images, it would have been taken down, and then you would have been questioned with the FBI for why you have so many images of half-naked girls on your YouTube channel. And I'm saying girls, I'm not saying teens, young teens, girls, you know, anybody under the age of 18. I mean, how can I expect you guys to be confident in yourselves through my message if I can't be confident in myself? you are not confident. You're not promoting any message outside, hey, it's perfectly legal for me to post these images up because they consent. They're minors. Minors cannot give consent, much like minors cannot vote. And in my policy, if you're not old enough to vote, you're not old enough to poke. So yeah, you should be thinking about that yourself. If you want to further protect yourself in the future, Onision, you should stop, look into the federal guidelines on what is considered legal and illegal, and then continue on from there. What you did is in fact wrong on a federal level, and you sitting there claiming that it was that you are doing something perfectly legal is not. Art does not involve minors being naked. In fact, if you drew a picture of a naked young male or a naked young female in an image, in as just being naked, just naked, you would be considered a pedophile and you would be arrested and have persecution pressed on you. And guess what? That's just a drawing. Take the same drawing and put underwear on them. You're still considered a pedophile. These are fictional things. These are fantasy arts, images. And you would still be considered a pedophile for it. It's why people who are artists, people who are role players, and people who are photographers are very cautious about who they take pictures of and why. They are very cautious about the images that they put up on the internet because they have to look at these images and say, will this get me in trouble? You don't do that. You did not look over those pictures and ask yourself, will this get me in trouble? And guess what? It got you into serious trouble. So yeah, doing this is not legal. Stop saying that it is. You're doing nothing more than just promoting your own self-righteous agenda, which, by the way, is nothing more than horse shit and lies. Until next time, this is Tiki Palmer signing out. Peace.